Hello everybody, I'm Dr. D. Kavita, Assistant Professor, Department of Biochemistry, Biotechnology and Bioinformatics. I'm Nashlingam Institute for Home Science and Higher Education for Women, Coimbatore, Tamil Nadu. In this module, you're going to look into the inborn errors of amino acid metabolism. Amino acids are building blocks of proteins, which are made of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and nitrogen. Biosynthesis or breakdown of these amino acids yield different products that are important in the body. Inborn errors of amino acid metabolism are as a result of accumulation of toxic metabolic products in the body system or as a result of inefficient breakdown of amino acids and proteins. Coming to the objectives of this module, you will be able to understand the amino acid metabolism. The metabolic role of amino acid is highlighted in this module. You will understand the basic genetic mechanisms which underlie inborn errors of amino acid metabolism. You will know some of the most commonly affected disorders. The most common inherited disorders of amino acid metabolism are phenylketonuria, alkaptonuria, albinism, maple syrup urine disease, homocystinuria. Let us discuss the first important type, that is phenylketonuria. Phenylketonuria is an inherited disorder that increases the levels of phenylalanine in the blood due to defective hepatic enzyme phenylalanine hydroxylase. Phenylalanine is normally oxidized by the enzyme phenylalanine hydroxylase to form the amino acid tyrosine and this in turn the normal biosynthetic route to tyrosine. From tyrosine, there are further connections to the biosynthesis of catecholamines, melanin, hormones, etc. However, when there is too much phenylalanine in the body's pool of amino acids, it must be eliminated either by excretion or by biochemical reaction. A defect in the transformation of phenylalanine will lead to an excess of phenylalanine and a deficit of tyrosine in the body. The excess phenylalanine will undergo side reactions that normally are undetectable. These unusual metabolites of phenylalanine can produce pathologies. One of the principal metabolites is a ketone derivative of phenylalanine. Hence, the disease is called phenylketonuria. This diagram shows the metabolic pathway of how phenylalanine is converted into a tyrosine. What are the symptoms of phenylketonuria? Intellectual disabilities or mental retardation, seizures, tremors or jerky hand and leg movements, hyperactivity, stunted growth, eczema, a distinct odor in breath, skin or urine that is often described as musty, lighter skin, hair and eye color than their family members. How do we diagnose this disorder? By estimation of plasma phenylalanine level, screening test for presence of phenylpyruvate with ferric chloride, administration of phenylalanine to a phenylketonuric patient should result in prolonged elevation of the level of this amino acid in blood, that is phenylalanine tolerance test. How do we treat this phenylketonuria? By giving diet having very low levels of phenylalanine. The diet can be terminated at 6 years of age when high concentration of phenylalanine and its derivatives are no longer injurious to brain. Now let us discuss the second disorder, that is alkaptonuria. Alkaptonuria, it's called black urine disease, is a rare inherited genetic disorder that causes urine to turn black when exposed to air, in which the body cannot process the amino acids phenylalanine and tyrosine that occurs in protein. It is caused by mutation in the HGD gene for the enzyme homogentisate 1,2-dioxygenase. This condition is inherited in an autosomal recessive pattern, which means both copies of the gene in each cell have mutations. The parents of an individual with an autosomal recessive condition each carry one copy of the mutated gene, but they typically do not show signs and symptoms of the condition. This is the metabolic pathway of how the phenylalanine should be converted into the final product. What are the symptoms of this disease? Brown or blue discoloration of the sclera of the eyes, stained cartilage that may be visible in your ear, darkening of the skin, particularly around sweat glands, chronic low back pain, arthritis in the hips and knees, kidney stones and prostate stones. How are we going to diagnose this disease? Gas chromatography can detect traces of homogentisic acid in the urine. DNA testing can look for the mutated HGD gene. What are the treatments available? There is no specific treatment for alkaptonuria. Large doses of ascorbic acid, that's vitamin C, may slow down the accumulation of pigment in the cartilage. This could slow the development of arthritis. Reducing phenylalanine in the diet has been shown to reduce levels of homogentisic acid in children. Next, let us see about the third important disease, that's albinism. Albinism is a genetic condition also called achromia, achromasiae or achromatosis. It is characterized by a deficit in the production of melanin and by the partial or complete absence of pigment in the skin, hair and eyes also. Most forms of albinism are due to recessive alleles passed from both parents of an individual, though some rare forms are inherited from only one parent. Mutation can also cause albinism. This hereditary disease can be found in humans, that's affecting all races, mammals, birds, fish, reptiles and amphibians. There are several types of albinism available, which are identified by different gene defects but can be divided into two major groups. The first one, oculocutaneous albinism, is a group of conditions that affect coloring, that is the pigmentation of the skin, hair and eyes. More than 10 forms are known. They can be differentiated by clinical presentation and biochemical and other features. Such albinos can be biochemically of two types, tyrosinase negative albinos, tyrosinase positive albinos. And the second type is the ocular albinism. Ocular albinism is caused by a gene mutation on the X chromosome and occurs almost exclusively in males. This type of albinism only affects the eyes. People with ocular albinism have normal hair, skin and eye coloring but have no coloring in the retina, that is the back of the eye. This is again the metabolic pathway which is indicating the albinic diseases. What are the symptoms of albinism? That's light hair, light skin, light colored eyes, reduced pigmentation in iris, reduced retinal pigmentation, vision problems, reduced visual acuity, involuntary eye movements, and increased light sensitivity. What are the diagnoses that's available for this disease? The most accurate way to diagnose albinism is through genetic testing to detect defective genes related to albinism. Less accurate ways of detecting albinism include an evaluation of symptoms by doctor or an electroretinogram test which measures the response of the light sensitive cells in the eyes in order to reveal the problems with eyes associated with albinism. What are the treatment strategies for albinism? There's no specific cure for albinism. Treatments and aids can help the symptoms and reduce the risk of damage to the skin. Precautions in avoiding exposure to UV light, using high factor sunscreen, protective clothing and hats are essential. Coping with eye problems can be achieved by seeking advice from optometrists and ophthalmologist. Surgery may be required on the ocular muscles to decrease some of the vision problems. Treatment of the eye conditions consists of visual rehabilitation. The fourth important inborn errors of metabolism is maple syrup disease. Maple syrup urine disease is an aminoacidopathy secondary to an enzyme defect in the catabolic pathway of the branched chain amino acids leucine, isoleucine and valine. Its abbreviated MSUD was so named in 1957 because of the characteristic odor of the urine and earwax of infants with the disease. The sweet odor is detectable as early as 12 hours after birth and is due to the presence of sotolon, the same compound responsible for the smell in maple syrup and fenugreek. MSUD is caused by mutations in an enzyme alpha-ketoacid dehydrogenase complex or BCKD, which is responsible for breaking down the branched chain amino acids leucine, isoleucine and valine. Accumulation of these three amino acids and their corresponding ketoacids leads to encephalopathy and progressive neurodegeneration in untreated infants. This enzyme is comprised of four subunits encoded by four separate genes. That's mutations in any one of these genes can definitely cause MSUD. There are four different types of MSUD, but thus far correlations with any particular genetic mutations are not easily defined. In addition to a genotype, this MSUD disease expression is influenced by other factors like the rate of growth, calorie intake, the frequency and severity of metabolic crisis, and the stringency of maintaining the therapeutic diet. The most common defect is caused by a mutation in a gene on chromosome 19 that encodes the alpha subunit of the BCKD complex. And this diagram shows the metabolic pathway which are involved in this MSUD. There are four types of MSUD. All are inherited genetic disorders. They differ by their degree of enzyme activity, severity, and age when the disease appears. The first one, classic MSUD. Classic MSUD is the most common form of this condition. In this form, the patient has little, if any, enzyme activity, about 2% or even less than that. And this is the most severe form of MSUD. Symptoms are present in newborn errors within a few days of birth. The second type is the intermediate MSUD. An intermediate maple syrup urine disease is a very rare form of the disease. It's a version of classic MSUD. The symptoms and age of onset of this type vary greatly. Individuals with intermediate maple syrup urine disease have a higher level of enzyme activity than classic MSUD, about 3 to 8% of normal activity. The intermittent MSUD. Intermittent MSUD does not interfere with normal physical and intellectual growth and development. It's a milder form of classical MSUD. Individuals have more significant enzyme activity, that's about 8 to 15% of normal activity. Symptoms usually don't appear until a child is between 1 and 2 years of age. The initial reaction often occurs when the child experiences stress, an illness, or an unusual increase in protein. Thiamine-responsive MSUD. Thiamine-responsive MSUD is a rare form of the condition that often improves with large doses of thiamine or vitamin B1. Symptoms in a child with thiamine-responsive MSUD usually occur after infancy. Even though thiamine can be beneficial, dietary restrictions also are necessary. What are the risk factors for this disease? The risk for having any form of maple syrup urine disease depends on whether or not they are parents or carriers of the disease. If both parents are carriers, each child has a 25% chance of receiving two mutated genes and having MSUD, a 50% chance for receiving only one defective gene and being a carrier, and a 25% chance of receiving one normal gene from each parent. If you have two normal genes for MSUD, you cannot pass the disease to your children. When two parents carry the recessive gene for MSUD, it is possible for one child to have the disease and the other children to be normal. However, children of parents who are carriers also can be carriers with one defective gene like their parents. If one child is diagnosed with MSUD, any other child will have a 50% chance of being carriers. They also may carry a risk later in life of having a child with MSUD. What are the symptoms of MSUD? Symptoms may vary according to the disease subtype. In classic MSUD, the most common type of the disease, symptoms become present in an infant within a few days after birth. The onset is usually triggered when the infant's body begins to process protein from feedings. So the symptoms are as follows: lethargy, weight loss, weak sucking ability, a distinctive maple sugar odor in earwax, sweat and urine, irregular sleep patterns, seizures, neurological deficiencies, developmental delays, feeding problems and poor growth. And how do we diagnose this maple syrup urine disease? Identifying the presence of maple syrup urine disease at birth is critical to prevent the long-term damage. In cases where both the parents are carriers and their child's test is negative for MSUD, additional tests may be advised to confirm the findings and prevent the onset of symptoms. When symptoms become present after the newborn period, diagnosis of MSUD can be made by urine analysis or a blood test. In a child with MSUD, urine analysis will show a high rate of keto acids. A blood test will show a high level of amino acids. The diagnosis of MSUD also can be confirmed with enzyme analysis of white blood cells or skin cells. What's the treatment for MSUD? If the infant is diagnosed with MSUD, prompt medical treatment can avoid serious medical problems and mental retardation. The initial treatment involves reducing the levels of BCAAs in the baby's blood. Typically, this will involve the intravenous administration of amino acids that do not contain BCAAs combined with glucose for extra calories. The treatment will promote the utilization of existing leucine, isoleucine and valin in the body, simultaneously reducing the BCAA levels and providing necessary protein. This treatment must begin very early to prevent brain damage. Babies with the disease must eat a special formula that does not contain the amino acids leucine, isoleucine and valine. As the person grows to adulthood, he or she must always watch their diet, avoiding high protein foods such as meat, eggs and nuts. Gene therapy is also a potential future treatment for patients with maple syrup urine disease. This treatment would involve replacing the mutated gene with a good copy, allowing the patient's cells to make a functional BCKD protein complex and break down the excess amino acids. Now, let us discuss the next important inborn errors of metabolism, that is homocystinuria. Homocystinuria is an inherited disorder in which the body is unable to process certain building blocks of proteins such as amino acids properly. There are multiple forms of homocystinuria which are distinguished by their signs and symptoms and genetic cause. The most common form of homocystinuria is characterized by nearsightedness, that's myopia, dislocation of the lens at the front of the eye, an increased risk of abnormal blood clotting and brittle bones that are prone to fracture, that's osteoporosis, or other skeletal abnormalities. Some affected individuals also have developmental delay and learning problems. Less common forms of homocystinuria can cause intellectual disability, failure to grow and gain weight at the expected rate, seizures, problems with movement, and a blood disorder called megaloblastic anemia. Megaloblastic anemia occurs when a person has a low number of red blood cells, that's called as anemia, and the remaining red blood cells are larger than normal. that's megaloblastic. The signs and symptoms of homocystinuria typically develop within the first years of life, although some people with a mild form of the disease may not develop features until later in childhood or adulthood. This is a very important metabolic pathway which shows this homocystinuria. And there are several types of this homocystinuria. They range from common to rare. No specific names exist for these variations of the illness. Instead, they are distinguished by their symptoms. Infants who are affected by the common form of this disorder generally experience mild symptoms. In fact, they may not even have symptoms that require treatment until they are older. However, the less common forms of this disorder have been known to cause more serious developmental problems, including impaired intellectual capability. The first type 1 classic homocystinuria, it's caused by a deficiency of cofactor pyridoxine, that's vitamin B6, and the enzyme cystathionin beta synthase. And the type 2 is due to a deficiency of the enzyme tetrahydrofolate methyl transferase. And type 3 is caused by a defect of the enzyme tetrahydrofolate reductase. More than 95% of patients with homocystinuria are type 1. Although this disorder is rare, surgical interventions and anesthesia care is frequently required for ophthalmologic, that's ectopia lentis, or skeletal manifestations. What are the causes of this disease? Homocystinuria due to CBS deficiency is caused by changes or mutations of a gene that regulates the production of the enzyme cystathionin beta synthase, that is referred as CBS. This mutation is inherited as an autosomal recessive trait. Genetic diseases, which are determined by the combination of genes for a particular trait that are on the chromosomes received from the father and the mother. Homocystinuria has several features in common with Marfan syndrome, including joint and eye changes. Recessive genetic disorders occur when an individual inherits the same abnormal gene for the same trait from each parent. If an individual receives one normal gene and one gene for the disease, the person will be a carrier for the disease but usually will not show symptoms. The risk for two carrier parents to both pass the defective gene and therefore have an affected child is 25% with each pregnancy. The risk to have a child who is a carrier like the parents is 50% with each pregnancy. The chance for a child to receive normal genes from both parents and be genetically normal for that particular trait is 25%. The risk is the same for males and females. What are the signs and symptoms of this disease? The symptoms will depend on the type of homocystinuria. Symptoms generally develop during the first years of life. However, some people experience symptoms during adulthood also. The most common forms of this disorder may involve the following symptoms: dislocation of the lenses in the eyes, nearsightedness, abnormal blood clots, osteoporosis, learning disabilities, developmental problems, chest deformities, long spindly arms and legs, scoliosis. Less common variations involve these additional symptoms also: megaloblastic anemia, and anemia which is involving larger than the normal red blood cells, seizures, failure to thrive, intellectual disabilities, movement and gait abnormalities. What are the diagnoses for this homocystinuria? Doctor may look for certain signs to determine whether the child has this condition. An extremely thin or tall child is more likely to have the condition. Additionally, the doctor may search for signs such as chest deformities, curvature of the spine, and dislocated lenses in the eyes. An eye examination can reveal a dislocated lens if the child experiences double or significantly impaired vision. What are the tests available? An X-ray to look for signs of osteoporosis, genetic testing to look for one of the genes which are involved in the disorder, a liver biopsy and enzyme assay to check enzyme activity, an amino acid screen to check for the excess homocysteine, and also a skin biopsy. What are the treatments available for homocystinuria? There is no cure for homocystinuria. However, just under half of people respond to high doses of vitamin B6. Those who do respond will need to take vitamin B6 supplements for the rest of their lives. Those who do not respond will need to eat a low methionine diet. Most will need to be treated with trimethylglycine. Neither a low methionine diet nor medication will improve existing intellectual disability. Medication and diet should be closely supervised by a physician who has experience treating homocystinuria. Taking a folic acid supplement and adding cysteine to the diet are helpful. So to conclude the inborn errors of amino acid metabolism, a number of serious human diseases can be traced to genetic defects in the enzymes of amino acid metabolism. The phenylketonuria, due to a defect in the enzyme phenylalanine hydroxylase, is characterized by failure of growth, seizures and mental retardation. Alkaptonuria causes the accumulation of homogenitate, which undergoes oxidation followed by polymerization to produce the pigment alkapton. Deposition of this alkapton in tissues causes the achronosis, which is associated with arthritis. Melanin, the pigment of skin, hair and eyes, is produced from tyrosine. Lack of melanin synthesis, mostly due to the deficiency of this enzyme tyrosinase, causes albinism. Maple syrup urine disease, it's called as MSUD, is a branched chain ketoaciduria. It's an autosomal recessive metabolic disorder affecting branched chain amino acids. It is one type of organic acidemia. The condition gets its name from the distinctive sweet odor of affected infants' urine, particularly prior to diagnosis and during times of acute illness. Homocystinuria, it's also known as cystathionine beta synthase deficiency or CBS deficiency, is an inherited disorder of the metabolism of the amino acid methionine, often involving cystathionine beta synthase. It is an inherited autosomal recessive trait, which means a child needs to inherit a copy of the defective gene from both parents to be affected.